India's number one tech company, Tata Consultancy Services, was recognized and felicitated with the Indian MNC of the Year Award. We caught up with the CEO and Managing Director, N. Chandrasekaran, on the sidelines.
Well, we continue our special conversations here at the IMA Leadership Awards. Joining us now is N. Chandrasekaran of TCS. Chandra, appreciate you joining us. Congratulations for another award. I'm not going to start by asking you about TCS. Let me start by asking you about Cognizant, because like you, Cognizant has been right up there beating street expectations. Today, they revised downward their guidance for calendar year 14 from 16.5% to about 14%, citing lack of visibility as far as conversion of sales cycles are concerned. Does that concern you, and do you believe that this could have implications for the IT sector in general?
I have not really read their announcement. But I think from my perspective, the market is quite strong. Customers are spending money. Technology adoption is on the increase. Especially the US and the European markets are doing well. So I do believe that the industry and the broader market will continue to do well. There may be individual specific issues from time to time, but overall...
So no change in visibility. I mean, you've just announced your quarterly numbers, but
no change in visibility as far as you're concerned.
Well, congratulations on another milestone, a market cap milestone that TCS has achieved. What's the next one on your horizon? What's the next target?
I don't know, Shira. I have no specific targets. I think as long as we can... keep addressing what we need to address from a customer perspective. Mm. I think there is plenty of opportunities in this industry. There will always be aberrations.
But are you feeling the burden of expectations? Because within the group, you're the engine, you're the heart and soul.
No, I don't think too much about it, too much about expectations, because market always, you know, has a way of going out of bounds and coming back, correcting itself, etc. So you can't get carried away by that. Sometimes it just goes up, you don't know why. Sometimes it comes down, you don't know why.
But what's your sense about the domestic market, Chandra? And there's been a lot of talk about tenders, especially with to do with railways and so on and so forth. How interesting is the domestic opportunity looking at this point?
The domestic market is a very large market. I think it's a market which has huge potential. But last few years has been quite tough. As I have said in the past, things have not moved. And we have seen a delay in decision making. We have seen a tremendous slowdown in the way the technology adoption was happening, both in the public sector and in the private sector. I think the mood is positive now, a bit. I do think that the new government will adopt technology in a significant way. So while I don't expect immediate ramp up in the next quarter or two, but over the next 4-6 quarters, I do believe that the technology adoption in India will pick up, and it's going to be a very buoyant market again for the IT companies.
How are you reading the comments that John Kerry made when he was here in India as far as the visa issue is concerned? And he said that the Obama administration is open to some amendments to the immigration bill to perhaps take into consideration the concerns that Indian IT has raised. How do you respond to that?
I think it's a very positive comment, and I read that also in the media. That's a big positive. So as long as we can have the policy that is addressing the US requirement at the same time, provides clarity and addresses our concern, I think it's a good thing. We understand that, you know, there has to be jobs that need to be created, and that's a requirement in every market today. And we are sensitive to that, and we will do everything that we need to do. But it's a very positive comment. I was quite happy to be there.
How strong is the U.S. economy looking, and you know, specifically from a business point of view, because the economic data coming in from the U.S. is looking strong, which is now concerning investors that the Fed may in fact move as far as rate hikes are concerned sooner rather than later. Are you seeing a tangible difference as far as confidence in with your U.S. clients are concerned?
I have always gone by what I hear from customers. Then I take the macro view. I don't take the macro view first. But having said that, this time I'm positive on both counts. What I hear from customers is that they are going to adopt technology. Clearly, there is allocation of budget towards transformation projects, whether it is in cloud infrastructure or other digital initiatives, across the board, across industries. So I definitely think that from the client's point of view, the market is strong. And US declared a 4% GDP growth, which is pretty strong. So I really feel that US is going to do well, and that's going to drive growth across sectors. So I am very positive on the US economy. Regarding the Fed, I can't comment. I'm not an economist.
But in terms of pricing, Chandra, do you believe that the pressure that we've seen on pricing, and especially given the kind of competitive intensity we're seeing specifically amongst your peers here in India as well, do you believe that the pricing pressure is going to ease anytime soon?
So we have been able to operate on a stable pricing environment. We have maintained that. In terms of increasing pricing, that will only happen when there is a large-scale adoption of digital, which I think is beginning to happen. It will take some time. When there is a large-scale adoption, you will see a pricing uptick. But as of now, I think it is possible to operate in a stable pricing regime for the next few quarters.
Chandra, always a pleasure speaking to you. Thanks very much for joining us, and wish you the very best of luck.
Thank you, Shireen.
Not just business leaders, there were other achievers who were recognized and felicitated for their exceptional contribution in the arena of business, governance, cinema, and many more.
I think it's a great event. IMI is a great organization. They recognizing my company gives entire NTPC and its staff a great high. It just goes to show that we are doing things right. That's how I'll put it.
You know, I think the award for Samsung is a great honor for us. I think it's a recognition for Samsung's efforts to better contribute to the development of the Indian economy and Indian society. So we will keep doing, you know, that kind of jobs.